By the end of this video, you'll know how to create a wooden side table in Fusion 360. This video is my design solution for the second Fusion 360 weekly challenge. If you would like to participate in the free weekly challenge, then click the link down below in the video description and check out this week's challenge. I should also state that this design is not my original creation. I saw something just like it on the internet, and I thought it would be a quick and fun thing to model. To get started, I'm going to first create a new component. I'll select the Assemble drop-down list, and then I'll click the New Component option. Before clicking OK, I'll rename this component Wood Side Table. This design looks complex, but it's actually pretty simple. I'll draw the side profile, which will be used as the path of the table, as I sweep a rectangle along the path. To create the side path, I'll create a new sketch on the XZ origin plane. I'm simply going to toggle open the origin folder in the Fusion 360 browser. Then, I'll right-click on the XZ plane and I'll select Create Sketch. I'll now hit the keyboard shortcut letter L as in Lima to activate the line command, as I'm going to use a series of lines to create the shape and then I'll fillet the edges. First, I'll click on the center origin and I'll drag my mouse towards the top. I'm going to type out 500 millimeters for the distance, and I'll hit the Tab key to lock the dimension in place and to switch to the degree input field. Then, I'll type out 105 degrees for the degree input field, followed by clicking with my mouse to set the line in place. With the line command still active, I'll draw a line to the left. I'll make this line 430 millimeters in length, and I'm going to click to set the line in place where it snaps into place at 180 degrees, creating a horizontal line. For the next line, I'll head down towards the bottom, and I'm going to make this line the same as the first. I'll make the length of the line 500 millimeters, followed by the Tab key to lock the dimension in place. Then, I'll type out 105 degrees for the degree input field, followed by clicking with my mouse to set the line in place. Next, I'll create a horizontal line to the left. This line will be only 110 millimeters. Then, I'll hit the Tab key to lock the dimension in place, and I'll click to set the line in place. Last but not least, I'll create a line heading back towards the top. I'll make this one 400 millimeters, and I'll once again hit the Tab key to lock the dimension in place. Then, I'll type out 105 degrees for the degree input field, followed by clicking with my mouse to set the line in place. Now that I'm done with the line command, I'll hit the Escape key on my keyboard to exit the command. The last thing that I want to do with this sketch would be to add fillets or rounded edges to the corners, so the sweep tool has a nice smooth surface at the corners. Before doing this, I'll go ahead and move all these dimension lines out of the way so it's easier to work with this sketch. I'm going to simply click and drag on each dimension one by one, and I'll drag them further away from the sketch geometry. I can now add fillets to the corners. I'm going to activate the Sketch Fillet command from the Sketch drop-down list, which is not to be confused with the Modeling Fillet command. Once the Sketch Fillet tool is active, I'll click on the corner points where the lines meet. After clicking the first corner, I'll type out a fillet radius of 50 millimeters. Then, I'll click on the rest of the corner points, or I'll have to click on the two lines that meet at the corners in order to apply fillets to them. Once all of the corners have fillets applied, there should be 4 in total. Then I will hit the Stop Sketch button in the toolbar. One important thing to note before I move on, generally, I always recommend using the Model Fillet command and to avoid adding fillets to the sketch geometry when possible. The reason, as you'll see in the lower right corner, is that sketch fillets will oftentimes mess up the constraints you had applied to your sketch geometry. However, this is one use case where it makes sense to use the Sketch Fillet command. We want the fillet to be applied to this sketch, so our sweep path follows this as one continuous line. If we tried to use the Model Fillet after the fact, then it's likely that we would get holes or awkward gaps at each intersection. In order to use the sweep tool, you'll need a closed profile and a path for the profile to follow. We just created the path, so let's go ahead and create the closed profile. Typically, the closed profile works best when drawn at one end of the path. In this case, I'll draw a rectangle at the beginning of the path. To do so, I'll right-click on the XY origin plane, and I'll select Create Sketch. Then, I'm going to use the arrow to the top right of the view cube to look at this model with the X-axis running vertically. I'm going to hit the keyboard shortcut letter R, as in Romeo, to activate the rectangle command. I'll click on the center origin, drag out with my mouse, and I'll make the height 18 millimeters, followed by the tab key to lock the dimension in place. I'll make the width of the rectangle 500 millimeters. Then I'll click to set the rectangle in place. Right now, the edge of the rectangle aligns with the path, and I actually want this to be centered with the path. To do this, I'm going to use the midpoint constraint. However, I'll first need to delete the coincident constraint that was automatically applied when I used the origin point. I'll hit the Escape key to make sure that I don't have any commands active. Then, I'll select the coincident constraint, and I'll hit the Delete key on my keyboard. Next, I'll select the midpoint constraint, or the triangle icon, in the sketch palette. Then I'll select the bottom horizontal line, and second, I'll select the origin point. You'll see that snaps the rectangle into the middle, and the center of the closed profile now aligns with the sweep path. Finally, we're now ready to sweep the object. I'm going to activate the sweep command by selecting it from the Create drop-down list. Then, I'll select the rectangle that I just created as the sweep profile shape. Next, I'll click the path selector in the dialog box. I'll select the path that we initially created. I'll make sure that all parts of the line path are selected, as even though I have the chain selection option checked, which is supposed to connect all the touching line segments, I found that sometimes sketch fillets can cause issues with these scenarios. Once everything looks good, I'll click the OK button in the sweep dialog box to confirm the results. To finish up this side table, we'll want to add a hole in the left side using the slot command. I'm going to activate the center point slot from the slot flyout menu that's located within the sketch dropdown list. Then, I'll click on the left outer face of the model, and I'm just going to guess the placement for now, except I'll make sure that I click on the vertical Z axis. Then, I'll make the width of the left half of the slot 70 millimeters. I'll then type out 50 millimeters for the height or the diameter of the circles. Now that we have the slot sketched out, we'll simply need to extrude cut it. I'll hit the keyboard shortcut letter E as in echo to activate the extrude command. I'm going to select the slot profile, I'll change the operation in the dialog box to the cut option so it cuts through the model. Then I'll change the extent type to the two object option. Now this will allow me to select the inside face of this part of the model, ensuring that the cut always cuts all the way through here, even if I update the thickness of the model later on. Everything looks correct, so I'll click the OK button in the extrude dialog box to confirm the cut operation. The last thing I want to do to the model would be to add fillets or rounds to the edges of the model, similar to what would be done with a roundover router bit. I'll hit the keyboard shortcut letter F as in Foxtrot to activate the model fillet command. Then I'll select the four corner edges of the model, and you'll find that you'll have to reorient the model in order to easily select all four corners. Once all four corners are selected, I'll type out 35 millimeters for the fillet radius. I'm going to click OK to confirm this fillet. Then I'll right-click and select Repeat Fillet. Now the reason I'm using a separate fillet command is that I want to use a selection priority, and I found it doesn't work well when applying multiple fillet radiuses. For this second fillet, I'm going to select all of the outside edges of the model so we can add the nice smooth roundover to the edge of the wood. I could select them one by one, however, I'm going to use a selection filter to save time. I'll click the Select drop-down list, I'll find the Selection Priority Flyout folder, and I'll select the Edge option from the list. Then, I'm going to click and drag over the entire model. You'll notice this quickly selects all of the edges. However, I want to omit or leave out any edges that are not on the outside of the model. To deselect them, I'll simply click on them one by one. I'll also double check that I have all the edge lines selected around the perimeter, as you'll find that the selection priority does not always work 100% of the time. I'll make this fillet radius 5 millimeters, and then I'll click the OK button. Last but not least, I'll hit the keyboard shortcut letter A as in alpha to activate the appearance command. I'm going to search for wood, and I'll just drag and drop the bamboo light material directly onto the model. If you made it to the end of this video, then please let me know by commenting below if you'd be interested in some tutorials specific to woodworking. Now, these tutorials would include using user parameters to make dynamic models, and some other tricks that I found to be helpful specifically for woodworking projects. Be sure to comment below and let me know either way so I can gauge interest in this topic. As always, I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this tutorial. Support my channel and work by clicking that thumbs up icon and click on that playlist in the lower right-hand corner to watch more Fusion 360 tutorials. If you're new to the channel, be sure to smash that red subscribe button and click that little bell icon to be notified of more Fusion 360 tutorials.